Hello students, welcome to my class. We have already completed all this first and second unit syllabus, and today example I'm just going to revise about your chapter. So the chapter one, which is a part of the information that is actually from where, when and how we get the information, and this particular information how we get, that is the first chapter actually referring about it. So let us know about how this extension of the medieval period began, and also the different names of India that came, and then major developments, and also the sources of history. So these are the few things that is actually part of the discussion of this chapter. Now when we talk about the extension, it means when this extension has been taken place. So we have to understand about the 8th century usually starts and then ends with the 18th century. So 8th century the medieval period begins, and then 18th century the medieval period ends, and then on the say 18th century itself there is a modern period begins, and we will come to know about the modern period, that is in the class 8, about the arrival of the British and their influence and their occupation, their colonization. These are the things are part of the discussion in the modern period. So today let me know, let me ask you here the extension. For example, during your study, and since I have already elaborated, so you must have heard about the beginning of the medieval period. So here we have the two discussion. In fact, the medieval period actually begins on 8th this century, and here the first medieval period and then a second medieval period, means second half of the medieval period actually begins with the arrival of the Muslim, that is in India. So there are a few things which we will be talking about more on this. Okay, so the medieval period in India began from the 8th century and the continued and also till the 18th century the medieval period actually ended. And then during this phase of Indian history, numerous changes has been taken place, and in these changes you will be seeing that a variety of people have came to India, and how these people brought the new culture, new language, new religion, and new costumes, new food items, and new ways of technology, or maybe behavior. So these are the things that actually happen in this age. And so you will come to know that here the changes that has been taking place, especially in the Indian subcontinent area. So therefore, since the medieval period actually spread across many centuries, it was actually divided into two phases, as I have already mentioned. So the early medieval period we call it, and the late medieval period. So it means the medieval period, which have already rulers kings and queens, and followed by the Muslim ruler, the Islamic rule that came to India. So the early medieval period actually lasted till the 13th century, we understand, and then it covers the history of the palace in this 13th century. Especially you will be hearing about the palace, pratiharas, cholas and rajput. These are the few that name is mentioned. This is part of the first medieval period, or the early medieval period we can call it. So here the late medieval period begins from the 13th century and the last till the 18th century. So within this time period you will see the many changes that has taken place in India. So the late medieval phase covers the history from the Delhi Sultanate to Delhi Sultanate, and continues till the decline of the Mughals. So Delhi Sultanate, you have to understand about the arrival of the Muhammad of Ghori and Muhammad of Ghazni. These are the few people when they came and attacked, and then they looted, and then they went back, but some of them are also part of the existence here. So that is how we can understand. So therefore different names for India, how this actually began, especially when the varieties of people actually arrived in India. So here you will be understanding that especially on 18 September, that is in 1949, you know, the Constituent Assembly laid down one article, that is Article 1, Part 1 of the Indian Constitution, that actually stating this way, that India, that is actually Bharat, so we don't call the Hindustan. In a constitution, you won't find that it is called the Hindustan, but then in a constitution, we find that the name of the our India is Bharat. Bharat shall be the Union States, so that is actually mentioned here. And this implies that the constitution of India actually equals India to mean Bharat, so not Hindustan or any of the names actually. So we have to really say that India or Bharat in a Indian language. So it is believed that the name of Bharat was actually derived from the name of the legendary king. Now you must say legendary king, who is actually, that is a name is a Bharata, legendary king. So who was the son of King Dushyant and then Shakuntala, and was the ancestor of the Kauravas and Pandavas. So this is the part of the, this name is mentioned over here. So India is also referred to as a Hindustan. That is another part of the people actually mentioned. So this mostly done in the historical context, and the name Hindustan was derived from the Persian term. Now you must remember Persian people came in India, and so they have mentioned this or they term this name. So the Persian term actually Hindu. The word Hindu is a Persian for Sindhu. Now we directly we don't go for the Hindu, but perhaps there are meaning or there means to say that Sindhu, that is the name of the river that we have got, which is flowing from Pakistan to touching the Jammu and Kashmir, and then it is going to the joining there in the Arabian Sea. So here the name of the Indus River in Sanskrit actually known as the Hindu or Sindhu. So here, does Hindustan refer to the land that lay beyond the Indus? So it is not referred the people Hindu. It is not called Hindu, but we have the wrong conception with regard to this name. It is the land, it is the river, the valley, which is actually found just the bank of the Sindhu River. Okay, so that is we have to understand. So here, over the course of different periods, you know, the meaning of the names of Hindustan has actually changed drastically. And in the 13th century, Persian historians, that is Minhaj-e-Siraj, you must remember, Persian history, he is a Persian historian, what he says, used the term Hindustan to describe Punjab, Haryana and lands between the Ganga and Yamuna. So you must remember, Hindustan actually not mentioned the South Indian or maybe the North Indian or maybe the West Indian, but here they have mentioned the name of the place. Hindustan was actually described about the Punjab, Haryana and the land between the Ganga and the Yamuna. So these are the areas actually he mentioned or has term or given the name, that is actually Hindustan. And the use of the term Hindustan was actually more of a reference to the extent of the Sultanate that changed with the change in the political boundaries. So here, the Mughals who came to India during the 14th century used the term Hindustan to refer to their territory in India. So, the, you know, different rulers, different kings, when they arrived here, they have given the different names in order to make the people to know better. Otherwise, there are many names in India, many names. In one village, you see the different blocks have got different names, is it not? So, very much like confusing. So, therefore, they have given the one name, that is Hindustan, with the name of the river. So, the name India has also been actually derived from the Sindhu River. So when the Persian conquered the Indian subcontinent and Greece in the 5th century BCE, that time what happened? Sindhu became Hindus and slowly evolved to Indus to mark the land of Hindus. And by the 17th century, Indus transitioned into India. So you must remember, see how this name actually evolved. Okay? So it means you must remember the Sindhu became Hindus. Sindhu became Hindus and slowly evolved to Indus to mark the land of Hindus. So that is all. So by the 17th century, Indus transitioned into India. So that is how mentioned here. So different names came up in the different periods of the Indian history. And you can see one unique thing about the names that have been used to describe our country. In the fact that they have all been derived from the river Indus, which runs through Pakistan, Jammu and Kashmir in India, and the western part of Tibet. So these are the things I have mentioned. Okay, now in the previous class, you mostly actually studied about the ancient history, and in this class we will focus on the history during the medieval period, which was actually between 700 CE to 1800 CE. So we will be talking about this one. Okay, so with regards to the names, now are you clear that the name this Hindustan, how it has been derived from the Persian term, and how these people actually took this name into the culture or religion. Okay, so that is how it came here. So you must understand the names that is actually mentioned here are very much like unique. Alright, now next we will be discussing about the major developments during this period. During this period, you know, varieties of things happened. And you know, the medieval period of India actually witnessed a clear demarcation from the ancient period of the Indian history. So now see, Aryans made India. See, given here, the while the Aryans made India their home during the ancient period, and the Turks and the Mughals came and settled in India during the medieval period. So during the ancient period, the Aryans made India their home. So we can understand that whether it is a true or false. It means many of the historians may not be speaking about the Aryans. Today, for example, we have the different Brahmins and related with the Brahmanas. So these are all actually Aryans, it means. It means whatever the people from this North India especially, you will see that these are all people actually Aryans. That actually shows with this history. And then those people who were actually Dalits and Adivasis and tribals are actually original from the India. And they were actually, right from the beginning, they were put into a trap. They were kept aside. They were tortured. They were harassed. And this particular group actually was dominating and then enjoying the all the facilities. And so today we can see that there are caste discrimination. Why is happening? Because that these are the people are foreigners. Aryans, Mughals are foreigners. So both that they came and then both they are actually dominated India. And the people originally from India were suffered all through the years, all through the decades, right from the ancient period onwards. So that is how our Indians' origins were actually trapped and kept them aside, made them slave, and these Aryans and Mughals became the part of the this Indian soil, and they considered themselves that they are the original people of India. So that is a kind of a controversial issue actually. At many times, you know, they're claiming that they are from the original Aryans. Have Aryans are the original people of India. Sometimes you can see, you can watch in the TV debate, you know, there are people who are claiming. Okay, so I think we have to understand that both these people are actually foreigners, it means, and then how they became the dominant groups of this India. And today the ruling party, the political parties are also here, they are involved. It is there, not part of our country India. They are foreigners. That's why they want to rule on us. That is how we can understand. So therefore, here, the moment the Aryans in India, when they came and then they made the home, India their home, then Turks also came and Mughals also came and they also settled and they also remained here for centuries. And then how they have developed themselves in this country, dominating on the poor section of our Indian people. So a new culture actually originated the moment this people actually came, and then the culture actually integrated with our Indian culture, and then the culture was actually formed, a new culture was formed, and this new culture in fact has got neither the old one, the new one. It means the significance of this new culture is lost the old cultures. So that is how we can see. So medieval period began with the struggles between the Palas, Pratiharas and Rashtrakutas for the control of power in North India. You know, earlier days, most of the kings were always look for the power, look for the extension of their territory, empire. So this is the thirsty or hunger they had. Therefore, you won't see that there is a development. There is a they did not acquire the much development in the place of road and medical and town, city. These kind of things they did not put much because you know the religion also part of the this pressure on these people. You know, the Brahmanas, for example, were existing, or Sultan, or the Mughals, whoever were existed in this country, actually, they did not focus much on the to bring the renaissance in the town and the cities, and to make the things different. They only just thought of extension of their power and extension of their territories. So this is how country like India did not become a very beautiful town and cities, in spite of having the plenty of resources here. So that is how India. So therefore, you can understand that their influence are actually visible when they came, especially in the art and architecture of our country. And in fact, the Delhi Sultanate and the Mughal Empire have made such substantial contribution to the Indian heritage. So we can see today Taj Mahal, Agra Kila, or Red Fort, or Tipu Sultan Palace, and Mysore, and many other areas where the earlier people have constructed the buildings and all. So this is one of the advantages that they found. And then medieval period in India saw the rise of towns and commercial and crafts centers. So here you can see the commercial and crafts centers, but it doesn't mean that it became the as today we can see that a kind of a very bright and colorful and digital. Not like that. It is a very where there is a town, there is a town actually became, but where there is a village remain village and a miserable condition, actually people were suffering. So when you look at the 18th century the India and then a 20th century or 21st century India, if you look, then you will be understanding that how India's actually the appearance or the image. Okay, so that is very matters a lot. Okay, so here different centers of course at the time developed or rose, but the society also saw many changes in the social setup, such as the caste system and the transition of tribal societies. The Bhakti movement, Sufi movement, and the Sikhism also emerged in this period. So these are the few things are also happened. So unlike the ancient period of history, there are numerous literary sources for the medieval period. In the next section, we will discuss the source of available to reconstruct the history of medieval period. So in my next class, I will be talking about the sources through which we are getting the information. We are finding the different clues, evidences, so that we can understand about how this history began. So students, as you have already gone through these chapters, this is a part of the revision only. So as you revise, you try to understand each paragraph very clearly, and make sure that you learn and make it your own, and then prepare for your test. Okay, so thank you and have a great day ahead.